What's up, developers? Today we're going to build together a random loot table generator that is basically a weighted random system you can use for gacha. The outcome is what you can see on the screen, a function that takes a list of items with a weight that can be strings or even objects and picks them randomly. In this video, you will learn with me how I created this one with test-driven development. But if you want to use it in your project, you can install it with npm, yarn, and also deno, and the source code is already available on GitHub, link in the description. And now, let's open VS Code. Let's pretend this is an empty project, we want to create our generator object. We can do that by creating a new class, random picker. Let's give it a constructor that takes any for now. We can store our items list in a private field. Okay, I can't really look at that any, let's give it a type. What we're looking for is an object that has the original content and the numeric weight. Oh, again, not any, please, let's keep it generic. Back to the picker, we can now use our new type. Looks already much better. Before implementing the first method, we better not forget to write some unit tests. I'll begin with one to make sure the generator is created properly. We need to create an example list first, and then pass it to the constructor and expect it to be a defined object. No error thrown. The first method we want to create is pick. Let me create it empty so we can follow some test-driven development approach. Write the test first, then write implementation, kind of. We create again an instance of a picker and we pick an element. We want then to make sure that we returned an element that was in the original list. If we run the test now, it fails. Back to our implementation. The first thing we need is a random number, to be between 0 and the total weight of all our items. It's just the sum of an array, easy with a reduce. I'd like to keep it separated though, so let's put it in a separate method. Now, let's instantiate the accumulator at 0 and cycle through our items. At each iteration, we sum the item's weight to our accumulator. As soon as the random value we picked becomes smaller than our current weight, we can safely return the corresponding item. Why does this work? I created an in-depth video explaining it some time ago. It was for Unity, one of my games, but the algorithm is exactly the same. I will leave the link in the description, you can find it below. We will also need to add something here at the bottom, as TypeScript is expecting us to return a value at some point, but we will never reach it. Time to test and success! We cannot get 100% coverage because we will never reach the true statement at line 21. Let's cheat with a comment. Wait, what did I get wrong? Oh, sorry, Istanbul. The N. Okay. We can now pick one item. What if we want more at the same time? Pick many, right? We'll use the same approach, empty function first, write the test, and only after that the implementation. This time we also make sure the correct amount of items is returned before making sure they're all part of the original list. For the implementation, let's keep it simple for now. A for loop calling pick each time. And it works. However, at this point we calculate the total weight every single time, even if it does not change. Let's refactor a little bit and cache that number. We can do that, for example, once in the constructor. Let me run again the tests to make sure we didn't break anything. And yes, great. We can make this tool even stronger by adding some validation to the input. For example, we may want to check that the list is not empty. Oh wait, I forgot the TDD. Let's switch to the test file. So, I'd like to make sure there are no duplicates, so I'll add a duplicate test by adding bronze twice. I also want to test the list not being empty, as I was already implementing, and we also like to not have negative values. Now that the tests are written, back to the implementation. With a for loop, we can check that all weights are positive numbers, and since we're already in the loop, we can check if there are no duplicates. The best way is to use a set, and add items there every time. If an item is already on the set, it's a duplicate. As a final touch, we can make the errors say more information, such as what item is wrong and why. Now, npm run test, and yes, all three cases are covered. Since we're making a public tool, We might also want to add some utility methods with their tests. Get items, get weights, get total weight, and get count. I mean, why not? An extra feature we can ship is to export standalone methods to pick items, in case the user does not want to create the class every time explicitly, but only wants to pick once. The logic will be pretty much the same, we just create new random picker and call pick on the go. And same goes for pick many. As usual, I forgot the tests because I'm stupid. You should write them first. Let's go back on track. Anyway, those tests will be a little bit redundant as those two methods are barely a shorthand of the existing ones. Let's run again the test, and we did it! 100% coverage. It's not necessarily a sign that everything is covered, for example, some bad inputs might need proper testing, but it's a cool indicator that at least all lines are tested and we're on the good track. As I mentioned in the intro, the source code is available on GitHub and is already published as an npm package. If you're interested in open source, and you should, there are a few open issues on the repo. It's your chance to contribute and improve your online presence and CV. If you jump on the repo, don't forget to leave a star. I also wanted to show you how to publish this library on npm and deno, but to avoid overloading this one, I'll do that in a separate video. Make sure to subscribe to the channel to get notified when it will be out. And that was it for today. I hope you learned something from me. If anything, just write a comment and let's get in touch. See you soon!